guys.
Next batch. These are all a different one.
My first beach ball.
We got caught in between. Oh, there were fascist kids. They had all the safety.
I'm gonna be the asshole that throws it off.
And I knew that we had to leave.
The Echoplex, Liz, and everybody, like, this, you people and this whole area has been really good to us for the last, I moved here in 2006, and ever since, you guys have been awesome, so, rock and roll fist in the air to you guys.
Thank you very much.
And the Echo and Echoplex, and Echoplex Rising is booked by Liz, and Liz, our band would, she took a chance on our band when we had 10 people watching us at midnight, and she wrote me later that night and said that she liked my band and wanted us to play again after seeing us only bring 10 people. And so this is for Liz.
And also, it's great to be playing with Happy Hollows, because when we first started playing shows in Los Angeles, the Happy Hollows was one of the first bands we were playing with, and we really liked a lot.
We always looked up to them. Way to get all serious, guys.
Oh, whatever.
All right. This one's for you and you and you. One, two, three. We had dreams. They were better off dreams. So you kept them away from me. But the time will come. Yes, the time will come.
Yeah!
We had nothing but respect. We had nothing to regret. We had the winners on tours, and we had the losers to pick us back up again.
To the audience, it's kind of cool. It's like it was a Where's Waldo thing, because every time I look out, I'm like, oh, yes, yes, yes. And I get to see my friends. And look, there's Waldo himself, Farron. Farron's like the extra Henry Clay person. Every band we ever loved is selling out or breaking up.
To make a toast to my brother, everybody. I'm gonna start crying. I've lived with him for the past 2.5 years. He asked me to be in his band 11 years ago. And he's moving tomorrow.
ridiculous. Yeah, he's moving to Boston tomorrow, and it's the first time that... I feel like a baby. Anyways, the point of this is that he made me sing my very first song ever, and he wouldn't take no for an answer, and he ended up... I think I had to do it with my pants off, and he gave me a ton of beers, and at the beginning of the actual recording, you hear a beer can crush, and it's me, like, saying... fuck you, Joey, and I threw it at, like, the window, he made me do it, and it's still the first time I ever sang a song on a record. Yeah. To Joey.
Conversation, and nothing was cutting it. And it wasn't the way we were, it's just the way that we are now. He said, that's a shame. I said, let's go. Well, we were old enough to know better, but we were young enough not to care. Well, we were old enough to know better, but we were young enough not to care. You said it was the time, and you said it was just the wrong time.
Sadly. Here's more free stuff. No, it's not our last song. This is not our last song. We're fooling you again. Yeah, hold on. Yeah, again, behind us four idiots are wives, girlfriends, families, and friends that have been super, super supportive.
And babies.
And yeah, now a baby who I met last night. And he named her Adeline. Joe, take us away.
bag. This has about 10 vinyl pieces. Yeah, so this is it.
This is it, guys. Thank you so much.
Really, thank you all so much for this.
Charlie Brown.
One, two, three, four, five, six.